So let's go ahead and do this example where I want to look at each atom and I want to count the formal charges for all of them. What that means is I'm going to be looking at group numbers and I'm going to be looking at sticks and dots. So let's start off with the hydrogens, even though we already know that this fits the bonding preference. Remember that bonding preferences say that hydrogen wants to have what? One stick, one bond. But let's just do it anyway. Hydrogen is in what group? One. How many sticks does it have? One. How many dots does it have? Zero. So it's going to be one. According to my equation says that formal charge equals group number, which is one, minus sticks and dots, which is one. So it's zero. So this has a zero formal charge. Do you see that? But it also fits with my bonding preference. So as long as your bonding preference agrees with what you see, that's going to be zero. Let's do this with this oxygen right here. Okay. So first of all, does this oxygen fit my bonding preference according to bonding preferences? Yes, it does. It already fits it, so I could already put a zero here. Okay. But now I want to show you mathematically how it works out too. So we said that the formal charge equals the group number. What's the group number of oxygen? It's six. Minus the number of sticks and dots. So how many is that altogether? That's six. So then I would get a formal charge of zero. See how easy that is? So now we would do that for carbon, but is carbon fulfilling its bonding preference? It already is, so I can just put a zero there, okay? Then finally, there was a typo, just so you know. So notice that in your page, the oxygen did not have those lone pairs. Go ahead and just write those in, okay? That's just didn't copy, okay? So basically, for this one, the oxygen has six electrons total. It wants six electrons, I'm sorry. And it has six electrons total in terms of the valence, six sticks and dots. So this would also be zero. This is another way that you can fulfill your bonding preference by having a double bond and having two lone pairs. It still counts as two bonds and two lone pairs. So I hope that you guys see how if it fits its bonding preference, you don't need to calculate. But calculating is always just safe to do.